comes in and just you don't see it. And there's things off the floor that might get in the way. And so I think a lot of people are kind of just cautiously optimistic. But these two kids have really stepped up and filled the bill.
Hangos, count it.
Tell you, that kid is way above his years, too.
Well, both of them.
That finish right there is awesome.
Let's take a look in transition. Just a little stutter step. Pepperdine tries to take the charge, but like you mentioned earlier in the first half, Mike Hart got that call. Pepperdine doesn't. The official calls a blocking foul on, I believe that was Mills, or Willis, rather.
And the three-point play by Pangos. His first points of the night.
That's how with his full court pressure from Giu has really caused Pepperdine a lot of problems.
There's the deflection, then he runs it down. Merninghoff, three ball, corner. Rebounded Baker. Gonzaga on an 18-2 run. There's a quick shot, way off by Eaton. Baker, the rebound, putback is good. Tango spin.
Good patience here.
Very good patience. 15 on the shot clock. Tango's for three.
That's a good shot. Leave the clock. About 15 seconds left. They swing the ball about three or four times. Continue to shift that Pepperdine defense. You end up with a good look at the top of the key for Pangos. I tell you what, let him square up and set his feet. You expect that ball to go in.
And you saw the graphic there, 1 of 7 against Xavier, but the one he hit
might have been the dagger.
It was sick. I mean, it's just a great, great, great shot. Bell in transition lay-in. Richard, I get excited watching this sort of stuff. I get excited. You know, we've been around this program for a while now, and it's to have those teams with all those seniors, you kind of know their ceiling.
Sure.
But to watch it, this is the most exciting season, or this type of team is the most exciting for me to watch. You see them progress and grow. There's a three-point shot
Harold
made by Harold.
Yeah. Well, thing I like about Pangos and Bell, yeah, sure, they're talented. There's no arguing that, but, you know, they love the game. They have no ego. They're coachable. That really bodes well for their future and this program's future. There's no doubt.
Travel called on Merninghoff there. He didn't like
good,
the call.
Good minutes, though, for Merninghoff. Three rebounds, 1 of 2 from behind the arc, 3 points, has himself a block. Was at the right place at the right time defensively for the most part. Those are solid minutes. You know what they say, you earn your playing time in practice, you extend it in games. You know, so the coach, you know, you earn 5 minutes after a good week of practice and you play well in those 5 minutes. Next time you're out there on the floor, it might be 8 minutes. And that's how that progression happens, particularly for a young player like Merninghoff.
And the deflection by Dower on the floor. Pepperdine keeps possession. 19 on the shot clock. So Dower still on the floor with an 18-point lead. Spangler, number 15 on the floor for GU. 10 on the shot clock. Lowry forced to do it himself maybe here. Nope, now Baker with it. Barely got it off.
Just bad offense from Pepperdine. One ball swing. You take a contested shot.
You know, when Pangos took that shot, he had some extra time. He thought he was going to make that, didn't he?
It looked good from where we were at.
38-20 the score. Pangos let it rip. Well, Gonzaga started strong. Then they went through a bit of a rut. But they finished that first half shooting over 40%. They have an 18-point lead on the Pepperdine Waves. Rob Sacre with a smile. Bell Jr. leading all scorers with 12 points on 4 of 6 shooting, couple of rebounds. It's halftime in Spokane. We'll be right back. And welcome back to the McCarthy Athletic Center. Time now for tonight's Arby's trivia question. How many consecutive seasons have the Zags opened WCC play with a win? Is it 16, 13, 9, or 6? Text your answer to 27297. We'll have that answer a little bit later in the show. Greg Heister, Richard Fox, courtside, getting ready for the start of the second half. And I'd be remiss if I didn't say hello to my buddies, Ryan and Fritz.
Oh, yeah?
Watching the game tonight, sending me critiques by text messages. And I just wanted to pass along that I think you're doing a wonderful job. Me, on the other hand,
thank you very much.
Me, on the other hand, we're not sure about.
Well, I'm sure if they had my number, I wouldn't be getting as nice a text as I would hope. But at least they're watching. That's nice of them.
Yeah, it is. Okay, here we go. Zachary, Pangos, Hart, Harris, and Bell on the floor. For Pepperdine, we've got Willis, Harold, Lowry, Darby, and Moore. That shot is off by Harold. And now Pangos. Harris for three. Good look by Elias.
Yeah, it's a little quick in the shot clock, but he's open. Given how well he's shooting from behind the three-point line, you don't want to discourage a guy when he's feeling that good from behind the arc. That's 20. It.
Good.
I was just going to say, you know, Pepperdine's going to come out here, you know, embarrassed a bit here in the first half, down 18. They're going to come out with some energy. You have to believe Marty Wilson got into them a little bit, trying to fire them up a little bit. Gonzaga needs to respond with the same type of effort.
There's a block by Hart. And then the turnover inside. Bell. Three. That rattles out. Zachary with the rebound. Lost the grip. And it's run down by Lowry. Now Willis with it. Moore. That one rattled around like it was a pinball game.
A nice move, though. Really, the first time Moore's been able to go one-on-one inside. And single coverage, he's effective around the rim and can step out and knock down a jump shot.
Foul inside.
I tell you what, the two-man game between the bigs for GU is about as good this year as they've had it over a number of years. All three guys that play minutes, Dower, Harris, and Zachary, are always looking for each other. You know, they do the right thing. The first look is to get myself going. Do I have a move? You know, what's the right play? But if I get doubled or I'm not comfortable, where's my partner? And more often than not, they make the right decision, and they get a lot of easy buckets that way.
Harold picks up his third personal foul. That's Pepperdine's first foul this half. But now the phone's lighting up. I got everybody wanting to say hi. So, Dana, I can't say hi.
None of my friends must be watching because my phone is, yeah, very supportive.
18-point game. And now the pressure again.
You had some success with this in the first half. Pepperdine wasn't very comfortable trying to break this full-court press from GU. Do a nice job here, but this is another way to speed up a team that likes to keep things slow.
Lowry missed the shot, took it right back. And now he's chased by Hart. They took it away from him. Pangos over Moore. What a finish. 20-point lead.
How about that? Three great plays.
It was like, you messed with my buddy, huh? I'll get you.
Hey, tell you what, Lowry was a nice heads-up play. Mike Hart, once again, not quitting on anything. And then a tough finish for Pangos over Moore inside.
Darby missing the shot. Pangos. That one rattled out. Zachary up high to get the rebound. Bell for three.
His offensive rebounds. There's no better time to look to get a shot from the three-point line than off those offensive rebounds. Traditionally, that defense is going to be near that rim, collapsing down to try to get the defensive rebound. You get that offensive rebound, not comfortable putting it up as a big turn, face that three-point line and find yourself a shooter. Right here.
Yeah, the steal by Hart, got it to Pangos, and then high off the glass. Gonzaga coming alive. Look at the rebound by Zachary. Out to Bell. And bang. Whoa. I know nothing about dancing. Can you give her a grade there, Richard? We used to call you the big sexy.
A for effort.
You must know something about the dance floor.
A for effort, technique. Still needs a little work. Needs a little work, but I love the effort. The passion's there, and that's the first thing you need when you want to start dancing.
Gary Bell now a career high 15 points in this game. Here's Darby on Harris. He'll get a free throw.
First bucket for Darby, a tough one. Thought that was pretty solid defense from Harris, standing straight up. Definitely some contact in the body, but. Now Darby finds a way to finish it now. First bucket of the night, only 2 points, 1 of 5. He has really struggled to get himself going. You know, part of his game is predicated on getting out in transition, finishing at the rim, but Pepperdine just unable to get enough stops to create something on the offensive end going the other way.
...45-24 the score. Here's the lob, look out! Harris missed it, but grabbed it right back. He caught it on the other side. I don't think I've ever seen that.
Well, it must be nice to go to jump like that.
Seven on the shot clock, and Pangos in and out, back in.
Well, I tell you what, Pangos now 4 of 10, 11 points, only 2 of 7 from the three-point line after that make. But you look at that line and you say, you know, there's not a shot he took, he's taken so far, you say that was a bad shot. It's amazing how a guy who can score the way he does finds ways and opportunities within the context of the offense.
Foul called there on Jordan Baker. That's his third personal foul, two on Pepperdine, 16-15 to play second half. Gonzaga's offense, to me, seems to be growing as Harris just takes it upon himself. Drives that baseline in reverse.
There's a lot more purpose to what they're doing, and this is a group that few has been able to put a lot more in on the offensive end that maybe he may not have been able to do last season in particular. Makes them more difficult to guard. It's an unselfish group. And, you know, they're just becoming more and more comfortable, and their turnovers have steadily decreased as the season's gone down or progressed.
Whoa! Eaton went for the jam, missed it, and he's hurt at the other end. Ball goes out of bounds. It stays with Gonzaga, but Eaton's still on the floor, holding his back. May have hit his head as well. Marty Wilson looking at the officials. He's not happy. 15-26 to play. We'll be right back. And welcome back. Gonzaga with a 50-24 lead on Pepperdine. Greg Heister, Richard Fox. The Waves second in the WCC in scoring defense. They only allow 61.5 points a game. A lot of that may be just because of what they do on offense, right? They slow the ball down. They limit possessions.
Yeah, they want to slow things down, limit. And that's, you know, offensively, they're happy with less possessions. It's on the defensive end where they really want to try to limit their opposition, and they do a fairly good job of doing that.
And now, well, we'll show you what Marty Wilson was upset about a moment ago. Not just that his player got hurt. And Gonzaga back on offense now. Harris inside, lost the grip. Picked up by Scowen. He lost it. Picked up by Harris. Up to Dower. Handoff. Harris. And he's fouled.
Not the prettiest back-to-back plays offensively.
Frankly,
but
quite ugly.
Yeah.
But fun.
Well, I tell you what, you know, right there, Elias does a nice job in the initial possession, getting the ball in that high post. Had the ball poked away. And Mike Hart again trails the play, able to get his fingertips on the ball, causes the turnover. And Sam with the heads up play, just give it, dish it back up to Elias, let the guy who's a little faster than you try to finish at the rim.
It was like it was a turnover on the football field, and he's trying to hand